Well, I saw Carl Perkins the first time when he was at his first session at Sun Records. And I felt a kindred spirit from day one, you know. I mean, he's like somebody you meet and you feel like you've known him all your life.
He's a wonderful, sincere man, and I love him. Always have and always will.
Carl Perkins could still be one of the biggest artists in the world. And he deserves it.
Why don't you lead me to this age of rock that's higher and higher?
I wonder why my mother wants to stay here for.
Carl Perkins was born the son of Lake County, Tennessee sharecroppers. He and his family worked the fields, and it was on this earthy foundation that Carl started his musical education when he was six. Even at this young age, Carl learned a lot of important things about life and music from his old friend, Uncle John.
Possibly one of the greatest performers of rockabilly is a dear friend of yours for years, Carl Perkins. Tell us about Carl.
Carl Perkins, the entertainer, was literally the whole package. He did things differently. He phrased differently. He had a different rhythm. He had a wonderful black-oriented rhythm mixed in with some bluegrass and country.
How come you say you will when you won't? Tell me that you do, baby, when you don't. Put your arms around me, let me know how it feels. Tell the truth.
The boy's name was Elvis Presley.
All right.
The year was 1954. The song is the one I'm gonna try to do for you.
Well, that's all right, mama. That's all right with you. It's all right, mama. Any way you do, but that's all right.
That's all right.
That's all right.
That's all right.
That's all right, mama. Any way you do. Well, mama, she done told me. Papa done told me too. That gal you're messing with, son, ain't no good.
That's all right.
That's all right.
That's all right.
That's
cat, but I'm sitting here wondering what about your boss, old Marco. Yeah, I'm sitting here wondering what about your boss. Big dog gets here showing what the little perkin done. Well, I'm sitting here wondering what the back of our told my gold. Look out.
Now, it might have started with the lonely call of a trumpet down by the river, or maybe one key struck on an old piano in a juke joint at the edge of town. One thing is certain, it all came together at the beginning of the century, and Memphis became the home of the blues. In the mid-50s, five young men arrived in Memphis, each searching for his own style of music. And by combining the heart of country with the soul of rhythm and blues, they found a new sound and changed popular music forever. Rockabilly was born. After creating remarkable careers for themselves, our legends returned home to make music together one more time. Along with Elvis Presley, these four gentlemen created musical history. Johnny Cash, Jerry Lee Lewis, Roy Orbison, and Carl Perkins.
From Memphis, Tennessee, where rock and roll was born, it's Johnny Cash, Jerry Lee Lewis, Roy Orbison, and Carl Perkins, with their very special guests, June Carter Cash, John Fogerty, the Judds, Rick Nelson, Ace Cannon, and Marty Stewart. Coming Home, a rockin' reunion, hosted by Dick Clark.
Now, it all started in a small storefront recording studio operated by Sun Records. And that studio was about to come alive once again with a sound that touched all of us. Today, we call it rock and roll. Oh, yes, you know, as you watch these four great artists walk back into this tiny 18 by 29 foot room where it all happened, we can only try and imagine what thoughts flashed in each of their minds after being away for such a long time. That jam was the beginning of a week filled with music and memories. Now, as we experience this celebration, you're going to hear these legends and their friends in very revealing interviews as they talked with our producer-director, Gene Wee. We'll also hear some very rare comments from two great musicians who are no longer with us, Rick Nelson and Roy Orbison. And we'll hear the exciting music these artists made together, music created by a love and a bond that could only happen at an event like this.
And something like this. I said one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready, go, cat go, but don't you. My wife stuck her head down the upstairs. We had two rooms up and two down, and she said, Carl, you're gonna wake up these babies. But I said, whose song is that? I said, it's ours.
Well, Nashville had country music, but Memphis had the soul. Lord, the white boy had the rhythm, and that started rock and roll. And I was here when it happened. Don't y'all think I ought to know? Yeah, yeah, yeah. I was here when it happened. I watched Memphis give birth to rock and roll. Lord, Lord, yeah. Well, a cat named Elvis, he bopped into the sun right off the street. Same blue moon of OKY, but he did it with a brand new beat. Yes, he caught him asleep and whirling out there by surprise. Jerked him up, he rang him out, he hung him out to dry. I was there when it happened. Don't y'all think I ought to know? Lord, Lord. Yeah, I was here when it happened. I watched Memphis give birth to rock and roll. Here's kind of the way it happened. Well, the drummer boy was the beating on drum, just rocking and it going wild. Bass little sticker was clicking and clacking, but doing it in a different style. Guitar strumming and piano pumping, and the lead man kicking out the blues. Guitar shaking singer was swinging and swinging, saying somebody blues wears shoes. I was here when it happened. Lord, I think I ought to know. Yeah, yeah. Folks, I was here when it happened. I watched Memphis. First rock and roll. What you think about it, little guitar? Come on, son. Folks called it the devil's music. Others said it wouldn't last long. 31 years since we started shaking, proves somebody was wrong. In 64, the Beatles and the Four were the rock and roll best friends. The Beatles and the Stones took the old beat home, and the world went crazy again. I was here when it happened. My friend, I think I ought to know. Yeah, yeah. Well, I was here when it happened. I watched Memphis give birth to rock and roll. Oh, yeah. Come on!
It's hard for me to believe that I influenced with that little simple guitar. I certainly didn't mean to mess up anybody's music. I just played it the only way I knew how. Still did. Carl Perkins is like a brother to me. We grew up just across the Mississippi River from each other. I've always been a fan of his guitar playing, especially, and the way he dances on stage. I've always wished I could move my feet like that.
The first real rock and roll record that I ever heard was Carl Perkins singing Blue Suede Shoes, you know, on the radio. And, boy, right then I knew what I wanted to do.
When they said in the beginning that our music wouldn't last, it'll be gone, it's just one of those things. It's going to go. There's nothing to it. It would hurt when I would hear or read that preachers were breaking our records and calling it the devil's music and putting us down, because I never felt that we were spreading evil. I thought it was something to make people forget and feel good. That's what it did for me. Without a doubt in my mind, that I'm one of the luckiest men that ever walked on this earth to be able to be called a part of what's happening here in Memphis.
It was probably like a family getting back, seeing each other after, say, 20 years, you know. It was just great to be, you know, just a great feeling in the room and everything. I think everybody had a good time.
When we started this whole thing going right, we could hardly say hello to each other for everybody around us and everything. But we finally got to pair off by ones and twos and everything, and by the end of the first day, while we had spent enough time with each other to feel like this was as good an idea as we thought it was, you know.
And back out again, you know what they say about trains.
It was great getting back in the old Sun studio. I really didn't think it was going to sound as good as it did.
When they would do their thing there, man, it was taking you back. But still, again, it was new too.
When Chips Moman decided to bring back four of the five people who started that whole world, Dick Clark said, take our cameras and our sound recorders and go down there with Chips Moman and make sure we don't miss history again. I don't think any of us feel that there was another thing we could have been doing at that time that would have taken the place of what we were doing. It'll never happen again, and we got to be a part of it. It was very special.
Four legends who helped change the course of American music getting together again where it all began. That was reason enough to celebrate. Who knows? It could happen at other centers of music around the country, whether it's the surf sound in California, beach music in North Carolina, the folk rock scene of San Francisco, the sound of Philadelphia, Motown, Detroit, or doo-wop in New York. From coast to coast, this country is rich with musical history and memories to be shared. It's America's music. And yes, indeed, the beat does go on. Thank you for coming home for our rockin' reunion. For now, Dick Clark. So long.